Mais attends, c'est un grand plaisir d'être ici aujourd'hui pour faire cette annonce au nom de la ministre Jean-Yves Duclos. It's good to see my friends Andrew, John, Monsieur Wichart, Albert, and the Bullers as well. I really appreciate you all coming out here today. Monsieur Minister Duclos from Ottawa couldn't be here today, but he asked me to extend his greetings to each and every one of you here on the traditional territory of the Anishinaabeg peoples, the homeland of the Cree peoples, the Dakota peoples, the Dene peoples, as well as the Inuit and the homeland of the Métis Nation, and it's also our home. We all live here together, and I hope we never ever forget that. I know everyone here who's in assistance today is as passionate as I am as when it comes to making every Canadian and ensuring they have access to safe and dependable housing. And we all have the right to sleep in a warm bed with a roof over our head. And it's our government's mission to support Canadians' needs across the housing spectrum, including providing shelter and services to those least fortunate among us. We are here today to support that goal. Salon Mission contributes a vital service to our city. Not only do they provide shelter for the homeless, but they also provide a range of programs and services that uplift and enrich those that they care for. The work Salon Mission does in providing educational and transition services, as well as ensuring every person's basic needs are met, such as food and clothing, is invaluable for any community. And that's why it's a great honor for me to announce the funding and the expansion of Salon Mission's shelter. This will make an additional 50 to 60 beds, adding to the 110 which already exist, and it will help broaden the services that Salon Mission does. Now, in total, the federal and provincial government are providing $3 million in funding through the Investments in Affordable Housing Agreement to help make this expansion a reality. And I'd really like to thank the Salon Mission and all their staff and their volunteers for all the work you do. It's really heartwarming because we see 1,400 homeless people in our city often wandering the streets, and I know none of us are, none of us have a stone heart. We all care, and we want something to happen. I'm really proud of the work that our Prime Minister is doing, and also of my colleagues in Ottawa, because this is a priority of the Government of Canada. We believe that all Canadians deserve access to housing that meets their needs and that they can afford. And when it comes to building an inclusive society where all Canadians have the opportunity to succeed, housing really does matter. So that's why the single largest commitment in the federal budget of 2017, which was just released in March, is housing. Budget 2017 commits to housing investments of more than $11.2 billion over 11 years, with much of that funding directed towards affordable housing. That's an incredible number. I was proud to be on the Finance Committee where I was making those recommendations to the Finance Minister and haranguing him day after day, ensuring that he heard that message that it is important. And these really are there to reduce the core need. And they will support initiatives designed to build and renew Canada's housing stock right across this country and ensure Canadians' housing needs are met for really everyone. Now, there's also a commitment for $5 billion for the National Housing Fund, which will address critical housing issues and better support other vulnerable citizens. There is also a commitment to a renewed partnership between the federal government and the provinces and the territories to better support shared housing priorities. And this is all after all the challenges that we must meet together. We can't do this by ourselves, and nor can you do this by yourself. We have this collective responsibility. In addition, there is commitments to support housing for Indigenous peoples, residents in Northern Canada, combating and preventing homelessness, and expanding and funding our funding to strengthen housing research and data collection, because you need data in order to know if you're doing well at what you're doing. Now, these are all part of the National Housing Strategy, which will be released later this year. And this is the very first strategy that Canada has ever had on housing. This is an incredible achievement. I've been working very hard, consulting with people of Winnipeg and Winnipeg Centre and across Manitoba, ensuring that our priorities are heard in Ottawa about what needs to happen in Ottawa to make sure that it comes back to the ground here and that we are able to achieve what we desire for our communities. And this is the first strategy that's ever been done nationally. This is going to help reduce core housing needs and lift more Canadians out of poverty, contributing to a stronger and more inclusive communities. And I look forward to hearing what the minister finally comes up with after all the consultations across the country. I'd also like to talk a little bit about faith, because I think faith is important about who we are as human beings. As an Indigenous person, often I talk about my spirituality as being important to me. The people who use Salaam Mission, not all of them are Indigenous, but I consider them all my relations. They are my brothers and sisters, whether they are Muslim, some of them might be from Asia, some might be from Africa, some might be from Europe in their heritage, but living here, and we all are in this together. And it's important for me when I consider the words of the Pope Francis, our Pope, about how he said that whether you conceive, how you conceive of good or evil, as long as you continue to do good day after day, as long as you continue to strive to make a difference in your communities, that is enough to bring about a better society. And I feel his words in my heart, and I hope many of us continue to believe that. I hope one day that we can eradicate poverty. But I also hope at the end of my mandate in 2 years, and I hope at the end of the provincial government's mandate in 3 years before we all go back for another election, is that we have made a substantial dent in the amount of people who are homeless in our city, that we have implemented a housing first strategy, like little towns in Alberta like Medicine Hat and Lethbridge. Because I think our children are counting on us. I heard you talk about your children, Scott. I know my children talk about this as well. They go down to a soup kitchen in North Point, Douglas, every Sunday, where they have many people who do gas sniffing, and they serve them a meal and with some of the children that accompany their parents. And it's my children ask me, "What are you doing, Dad?" And this is why I go to Ottawa, is to fight for those people whose voices often are not heard. And I think we should all do this. Every time I stand up in Ottawa, I really attempt to give your voice to those policies which are going to make a difference. Anyways, in the meantime, from the bottom of my heart, I want to congratulate Salaam Mission for all the work you're doing for our community, as well as thank the province and the city for their continued partnership. And I hope we can continue to build a partnership where our agencies and our civil servants and our bureaucrats can work together so that they can actually get this job done. And I'm excited to see how this project is going to develop over the long term, because it really is in our collective interest to make a difference in the lives of people. And this is going to be a fantastic addition to our community. It's not something we want, but it's something we need, and it's going to make a difference in people's lives. So, tapwe yakikitwa, merci beaucoup. C'est extrêmement gentil pour m'accueillir ici. Tapwe.
Just shake hands here for a second.
I really appreciate your hard work. I'm going to sit down beside Scott now. Slide him over. Don't want him to feel alone.